Lyft is doing what it calls rate adjusting. I call it a pay cut. In this video, I'm going to share with you what we know about this pay cut and how it may impact you next week. And stick around, because at the end of the video, I'm going to share with you the percentage of pay cut that we know of in two markets so far. Hey everybody, it is Jay Crater with The Rideshare Guy, and today we're going to talk about Lyft. Lyft just can't let sleeping dogs lie. In California, they're asking drivers to support them, to advocate against AB 5, which is this legislature, which they don't want. And at the same time, they're cutting rates in like a dozen markets. It's a bit tone deaf. So let's jump right in and tell you what's going on. And we've heard from readers in a dozen markets. And what I'm showing you right now are all the markets that are impacted. They are Cleveland, Dallas, Fresno, Houston, Miami, Orange County, Orlando, Minneapolis, St. Paul, Napa, Sonoma County, Phoenix, Portland, Salt Lake City, San Diego, and Tampa, which actually got a bit of an increase. But most markets are seeing a definite decrease. Two, is it a rate adjustment or a pay cut? Well, let's look at what they call it when they sent these emails out to our readers. Matching rates for high-end rides. We're adjusting the pay rates for Lux Black rides in Miami starting June 24th. We're making this change to match the local rideshare rates for high-end rides. Well, you can call it an adjustment. An adjustment can go up, could go down, or stay the same. But as you'll see, it's actually a pay decrease, and that is not good news for any of us who are drivers. So number three is, how big is this pay cut? So what I'm showing you here is a comparison of the rates between, in Fresno, between the old rates and the new rates. And then I put it into a spreadsheet, and you can see the rates for the base rate, the per minute, the per mile, all go down about 4%. So that is a decrease. And then in Houston, you can do the same thing here. And then when we throw it into the spreadsheet, we see a 4%, 3%, 4%, 4% decrease. So the rates have gone down. It's not an adjustment, it's a decrease in rates, and it's a decrease in how much you're gonna get paid as a driver if you drive the XL or the Lyft Lux Black. So what are my key takeaways? Well, if you look at this, I'm gonna share with you what one of our readers said. It's pretty great. He said, "And Lyft wants me to contact the state legislature and advocate on their behalf." Ha, quite unlikely. So we kind of are ending up where we started, and that Lyft is being a bit tone deaf here. You can't cut a man or a woman's rates, how much you pay them, the money they live on, and then ask them to do you a favor. Ask them to help you out. That's not gonna fly, okay? It's not gonna work. So that's my first takeaway. Second takeaway is, what's up? Why cut rates 3% to 4% to 5%? Of course, it affects your bottom line, but I mean, I keep coming back to, it's death by a thousand cuts. Uber and Lyft both, they just keep taking little bits away, chunk by chunk by chunk by chunk by chunk, and soon the levee is gonna break. The levee's gonna break. People are just gonna say, I've had enough of it, I'm not gonna take it anymore. And that's my big takeaway. It's just more of the same. Get to work on figuring out your plan B, because the hits are just going to keep on coming. And here at The Rideshare Guy, we will keep you updated on all of the adjustments or pay cuts that we see coming at us and coming at you as the drivers out there in the rideshare world. Hey, if you haven't signed up yet to be a member of this YouTube channel, go for it. We'd love to have you as part of our team. Every week we bring you two or three videos to keep you up to date on all the latest that's happening in the rideshare industry. This is Jay Crater with The Rideshare Guy. Thanks so much for listening and watching, and we'll see you on the other side. Be safe out there.